Unit 5, beta and gamma functions. In this unit, we will discuss beta and gamma functions, and their properties. Relation between beta and gamma functions. Evaluation of integrals, definite integrals using beta and gamma functions. So in this chapter, in this unit, we will discuss the following topics. One is beta and gamma functions, definitions of beta and gamma functions and their properties, relation between beta and gamma functions, and also evaluation of integrals using, evaluation of definite integrals using beta and gamma functions. First, definition of gamma function. Gamma function is defined as gamma n equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x to the power of n minus 1 dx for n greater than 0. This integral is also known as Euler's integral of second kind. It defines a function of n for positive values of n. So this is the definition of gamma function. Gamma function is a definite integral, so which is integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x into x to the power of n minus 1 dx. So this is the symbol gamma of n. Why we are writing gamma of n? After evaluating this integration and substituting the limits, so the function remains in terms of n only. Therefore, this is denoted by gamma of n, just like f of n. So gamma we are using to represent this function gamma of n. This integration is also known as another name, Euler's integral of second kind. There are different kinds of definite integrals. In this Euler's integral of second kind is gamma of n. So it defines a function of n, as already I explained. After the evaluation of this integration yields a function in terms of n for positive values of n only. So this is defined for n greater than 0. This is the definition of a gamma function. Now gamma of 1. Put n is equal to 1 in the above definition. We get gamma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x power n minus 1 dx. Now put n equal to 1, then 0 to infinity e power minus x to the power of 1 minus 1 dx, that is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x power 0 equal to 1. Therefore, this is integration of e power minus x is minus e power minus x limits 0 to infinity, upper limit minus lower limit. Therefore, e to the power of minus infinity minus lower limit e to the power of minus 0. Therefore, that is e to the power of minus infinity value 0 minus e power 0 value 1. Therefore, this is minus of minus 1. Therefore, gamma 1 is equal to 1. So put n equal to 1 in the definition of gamma function, we get gamma 1 is equal to 1. Now reduction formula for gamma n or recurrence formula for gamma n. Gamma of n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. This is reduction formula or recurrence formula for gamma n. Now by the definition of gamma, gamma function, we have gamma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x power n minus 1 dx for n greater than 0 for positive values of n. Therefore, gamma n plus 1 is equal to, put n equal to n plus 1 or replace n by n plus 1, e power minus x into x to the power of n plus 1 minus 1 dx. Therefore, plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled. Therefore, you can get e to the power of minus x into x to the power of n. Therefore, by the formula, I let this can be written as e power minus x dx. So, first algebra and then exponential. Now, integration by parts. Integration by parts. Integral of f of x into g of x. Now, first, integration formula f of x into integral of g of x dx minus integral of f dash of x into integral g of x dx. Into dx. By using this formula, we can write the above integration. This is equal to here f of x is equal to x power n, g of x is equal to e to the power of x. First, f of x, x to the power of n into integral of g of x e to the power of minus x integration is minus e to the power of minus x limits 0 to infinity minus integral 0 to infinity f dash of x derivative of x power n, that is n into x power n minus 1 into integral of g of x, that means integral of e to the power of minus x, that is minus e power minus x dx. This is equal to, for upper limit, x power n into e to the power of minus x, that is limit x tends to infinity into x power n by e to the power of x, e to the power of minus x, we are writing in the denominator e power x minus lower limit x to the power of n, that means 0 power n by e to the power of 0 minus into minus plus n is a constant, we are writing outside of the integral, integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x into x to the power of n minus 1 dx. Therefore, so this upper limit we are substituting, that is limit x tends to infinity x to the power of n by e power x. So, as x tends to infinity, so by L'Hospital rule, so we will get it as 0, because so after n times numerator becomes n factorial, e power x derivative becomes e power x. L'Hospital rule means separately you can differentiate both numerator and denominator. Since we get indeterminate form, so if you can substitute directly infinity, you get the infinity by infinity. That is indeterminate form. To avoid the indeterminate form, you can differentiate a numerator and a denominator separately by L'Hospital rule until the indeterminate form disappears. So for this, we can differentiate x power n n times, we can get n factorial. E power x, same n times, we get e power x n factorial by e power x. After you substitute x as infinity, we get n factorial by e power infinity, that is e power infinity is infinity, so n factorial by infinity, it becomes a 0, finite value by infinity is 0, here 0 by 1, that also 0, therefore plus n into e power minus x into x to the power of n minus 1, so this is a exactly the definition of gamma n. This is the definition of gamma n. Therefore, this is n into gamma n. Therefore, gamma n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. This is the reduction formula or recurrence formula of gamma n. Gamma n is integral 0 to infinity e power minus x x to the power of n minus 1 dx. So this is e power minus x into x to the power of n minus 1 dx is gamma n. Therefore, gamma n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. Now, what are the values of gamma for positive integers, positive fraction and a negative fraction and a negative integer? Gamma n plus 1 is equal to n factorial for positive integer. If n is positive integer, then gamma n plus 1 is equal to n factorial. So here you just remember this formula. Proof is not required. So gamma of 5 is equal to gamma of 4 plus 1. Therefore, by the above formula, this can be written as 4 factorial, that is equal to 24. So gamma of 5 equal to 24, 4 factorial. Second one, if n is positive fraction, then gamma of n is equal to n minus 1, n minus 2, n minus 3 and so on, n minus r into gamma n minus r, where n minus r greater than 0, positive. So we continue series of factors so long as the factor remain positive into gamma of positive last positive factor. So then we get the value of gamma n if n is the positive fraction. For example, here also you just remember the formula. Proof is not required here. Now, gamma of positive fraction, take any value, 11 by 4. So therefore, by the above formula, n is equal to 11 by 4. Put n equal to 11 by 4 in the above formula. 11 by 4 minus 1. 11 by 4 minus 2 into gamma of 11 by 4 minus 2. Because if you can continue another factor, 11 by 4 minus 3, it becomes minus 1 by 4. So you have to write the series of factors, product of factors. So long as the factor remain positive. So until the positive factor only you can write. So if we are getting negative fraction, so you stop there before you stop. So therefore, gamma 11 by 4 minus 2. From next factor onwards, we will get negative values. So we will stop this series of product where we get the last positive value. So therefore, 11 by 4 minus 1, 11 minus 4, that is equal to 7 by 4, 11 minus 8, that is 3 by 4 into gamma 3 by 4. Therefore, this is equal to 21 by 16 into gamma 3 by 4. So, gamma 3 by 4 can be obtained from the table of gamma values. Gamma 3 by 4 can be obtained from the table of gamma values. So there is a table for gamma values. From that table we can find the value of gamma 3 by 4. Next, note number 3, if n is a fraction, then gamma n is equal to gamma n plus k plus 1 by n into n plus 1, n plus 2 and so on, n plus k, where n not equal to 0, minus 1, minus 2 and so on, minus k. So therefore, for these values, if it is 0, finite value by 0 infinity, minus 1, so denominator becomes 0, that means it is infinity. So for negative integers, gamma function becomes infinity. For 0, minus 1, minus 2 and so on, minus k, it becomes infinity. So for negative fractions, so this is the formula to find the values where k is the least positive integer such that n plus k plus 1 greater than 0. It defines gamma of n for negative fraction for n less than 0. And k being the least positive integer such that n plus k plus 1 greater than 0. It defines gamma n for n less than 0. Negative fraction means for n less than 0, where k being the least positive integer such that n plus k plus 1 greater than 0. For example, gamma of minus 3.4. Now first, here n is equal to minus 3.4. Choose k as the least positive integer such that n plus k plus 1 greater than 0. Here n is minus 3.4 plus k plus 1 greater than 0. Therefore, minus 3.4 plus 1, that is k minus 2.4 greater than 0. Therefore, k greater than 2.4. So, the least positive integer greater than n plus k plus 1 greater than 0, that means least positive integer for k greater than 2.4, that means 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on are all the positive integers greater than 2.4. So, among these values, which is the least positive integer? 3 is the least positive integer greater than 2.4. Therefore, k is equal to 3. So, therefore, now by the above formula, put n equal to minus 3.4 and k is equal to 3 in this formula. Therefore, gamma minus 3.4 is equal to gamma minus 3.4 plus k value 3 plus 1 by minus 3.4 minus 3.4 plus 1 minus 3.4 plus 2 minus 3.4 plus 3. For here k equal to 3. Minus 3.4 is equal to gamma minus 3.4 plus k, that is 3 plus 1 by denominator n minus 3.4 n plus 1 minus 3.4 plus 1 n plus 2 n plus 3. Since k is the 3, therefore this is equal to 4 minus 3.4 gamma of 0.6 by minus 3.4 into minus 2.4 into minus 1.4 into minus 0.4. Therefore, denominator positive value. This is equal to gamma of 0.6 by 5696. 4.5696. This is gamma of negative fraction minus 3.4. Gamma of 0.6 can be obtained from the table of gamma values. Note number 4, gamma 1 by 2 is equal to square root of pi. You just remember this value, we will prove it later. Gamma of is equal to root pi. After, we will discuss the relation between beta and gamma function. So, we will prove this gamma of is equal to root pi. So, without proving relation between beta and gamma, we can also prove that gamma of is equal to root pi by direct evaluation. But it has somehow a lengthy process and somehow difficult. So, when compared with by using relation between beta and gamma function to prove gamma of is equal to root pi. So therefore, now next examples, problems. First one, examples 1. Compute gamma minus half. Gamma minus half. So just we proved now how to find the gamma of negative values. Now here n equal to minus 1 by 2. Choose k as the least positive integer such that n plus k plus 1 greater than 0. Therefore, n value minus 0.5 plus k plus 1 greater than 0. Therefore, k plus 0.5 greater than 0. Therefore, k greater than minus 0.5. So positive integer greater than minus 0.5 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So 0 is also non-negative number. So we have to consider only positive integers. Positive integers means 1, 2, 3, and so on. Among all these values, which is the least positive integer? 1 is the least positive integer. Therefore, k equal to 1. K equal to 1. Therefore, by the above formula, gamma of minus 1 by 2 is equal to gamma n plus k plus 1. N is minus 1 by 2 plus k is equal to 1 plus 1 by n minus 1 by 2 into n plus k minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So therefore, this is equal to, since k is equal to 1, you can stop only two products. So gamma of minus of plus 2. So therefore, that is equal to gamma of minus 1 plus 2. That is equal to minus 1 plus 2 into 2, 4. So that is 3 by 2, gamma of 3 by 2, minus 1 plus 2 into 2, 4. So minus 1 plus 4, 3, denominator is 2 by minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2 into plus 1 by 2. Therefore, this is equal to minus 1 by 4, reciprocal is 4. Gamma 3 by 2 can be written as positive fraction. I already given the formula in the note number 2, that is 3 by 2 minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 2, it will become negative. So we can stop here into gamma 3 by 2 minus 1. That is equal to minus 4 into 3 by 2 minus 1, 3 minus 2, 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2. Therefore, this is equal to 2 ones, 2 twos. Therefore, minus 2 into gamma of, just we written this value, square root of pi. So therefore, gamma minus 1 by 2 is equal to minus 2 into square root of pi. Then transformations of gamma function. Transformations of gamma function. Transformations of gamma function. By the definition of gamma function, We have gamma of n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x to the power of n minus 1 dx for n greater than 0. Now transformation, first transformation, so that is transformation, first transformation here, put x is equal to log of 1 by y to the base e. Therefore, from this, one by y is equal to e power x by the definition of therefore this implies reciprocal y is equal to r by cross multiplication 1 by e power x, that can be written as e power minus x. Therefore differentiating on both sides with respect to x. Now differentiating on both sides with respect to x, we get dy by dx is equal to minus e to the power of minus x. Therefore dy by dx is equal to minus e to the power of minus x. Therefore by cross multiplication dy is equal to minus e power minus x into dx. Therefore so dy is equal to minus e to the power of minus x dx. Therefore from this minus dy is equal to e power minus x into dx. And now the x variable is transferring from x to y. We are changing the variable x in terms of y. And what about the limits and the integration changes in terms of y? So lower limit of x is here 0, upper limit of x is infinity. If you change this integrand in terms of y, so how the limits will become changes? See here, we will see here. Now when x equal to 0, y is equal to e to the power of minus x, therefore that is equal to e to the power of minus 0, that means 1, y is equal to 1. When x tends to infinity, so equal to infinity is not correct, tends to infinity, y equal to e power minus infinity, that means y to the power of y equal to e to the power of minus infinity, that tends to 0, that tends to 0. Therefore limits becomes 0 to infinity becomes 1 to 0. Now substituting these values in the gamma n, say this is equation number 1, say this is equation number 1, substituting these values in equation 1, now equation 1 becomes substituting these values in equation 1, we obtain, so gamma n is equal to integral 2, 0 becomes 1, and upper limit is infinity, infinity becomes 0, e to the power of minus x dx, that is minus dy, and x to the power of n minus 1, x is equal to, we assumed that log of 1 by y to the base e. Therefore, now log of 1 by y to the base e whole to the power of n minus 1 into e to the power of minus x dx is equal to minus dy. Therefore, if you can multiply the integration by minus, by the properties of integration, limits will become changes. Therefore, lower limit becomes upper limit becomes a lower limit. So therefore, 0 to 1 log of 1 by y to the base e whole to the power of n minus 1 into dy. This is a gamma of a n. This is the one transformation of a gamma function. If you can substitute x is equal to log of 1 by y in the gamma definition, so that changes into integral 0 to 1 log 1 by y to the base e whole to the power of n minus 1 into dy. Now we will see second transformation when you substitute x is equal to ky in the definition of a gamma of n. Second one, put x is equal to ky, therefore differentiating on both sides, on both sides, with respect to x, we get dx is equal to k into dy. 1 is equal to k into dy by dx. By cross multiplication, we get dx is equal to k into dy. And what about the limits? Lower limit of x is 0 in the definition of gamma. Therefore, y is equal to x by k. Therefore, that is 0 by k. That is 0. 0 becomes 0. And when x tends to infinity, y is equal to x by k, that also tends to infinity. Therefore, 0 becomes 0, infinity becomes a infinity. So therefore, gamma n changes. Substituting these values in equation 1. These values in equation 1 we get. So equation 1 is gamma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x power n minus 1 into dx. Therefore, that is equal to 0 becomes 0, infinity becomes infinity, e power minus k into y. Since x is equal to ky, we assumed that x is equal to ky. And now x to the power of n minus 1, that is k into y whole to the power of n minus 1 into dx is equal to k into dy, k into dy. Therefore, this is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus ky into y power n minus 1 into k to the power of n minus 1 into k power 1. Bases are equal. We are adding the powers, k power n into dy. Therefore, by cross multiplication, this can be written as gamma of n by k power n equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus ky into y to the power of n minus 1 into dy. This is the second transformation of a gamma function. If we substitute x is equal to ky in the definition of a gamma, so this transformed into another form, that is integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus ky into y to the power of n minus 1 dy is equal to gamma n by k to the power of n. Transformation number 3. Now, put x power n equal to y. So therefore, then differentiating on both sides, on both sides with respect to x, we get x power n derivative n into x power n minus 1 equal to dy by dx by cross multiplication. This is a dy. Therefore, x power n minus 1 into dx is equal to dy by n. Therefore, what about the limits? When x equal to 0, then y is equal to x power n, 0 power n is equal to 0. When x tends to infinity, y equal to x power n, that also tends to infinity. Therefore, x power n equal to y implies x is equal to y to the power of 1 by n. X is equal to y to the power of 1 by n. Substituting these values in equation number 1, these values in equation 1. So that equation 1 is gamma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x, x to the power of n minus 1 dx. Integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x power n minus 1 dx for n greater than 0. Therefore, 0 becomes 0, infinity becomes infinity, e to the power of minus x, that is x is equal to y to the power of 1 by n, e to the power of minus y to the power of 1 by n into x power n minus 1 into dx, that is dy by n. Therefore, by cross multiplication, n is a constant, n into gamma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus y power 1 by n into dy. This is the another transformation of gamma function. If we substitute x power n equal to y, these are the transformations of a gamma function. We will continue in the next class.